Come a little closer. Come over here. I want to tell you something. Yeah, I am so happy. Do you know why I am so happy? Because I'm about to get a copyright strike. Yeah. It's not about the money. It's about the message. Let's go.
Hey, what kind of colored man are you?
I'm a soldier, Peterson. And the kind of colored man that don't like lazy, shiftless Negroes.
Well, sir, you ain't got to come in here calling us names.
The Nazis called you Schwarzer. You gonna complain to Hitler he hurt your little feelings?
It don't look like to me we could do too much to them Nazi with paintbrushes, sir.
You trying to mock me, CJ?
No, sir, Sarge.
Good. Because whatever an ignorant, low-class Geechee like you has to say ain't worth paying attention to. Is it? Is it?
I recognize, sir.
You a creep, Waters.
Sir, just joking, Pete. He don't mean no harm.
No, he does. I mean, we're taking her from them white boys.
Yes, you do. And if it wasn't for you southern niggas, white folks wouldn't think we was all fools.
Well, where are you from? England?
Buggy? Looks like we got us a wise-ass Alabama boy here. Yes, sir. Now, don't you get smart, nigga.
Get your fucking hands off me!
You wanna hit old Sergeant Waters, boy? Come on. Please. Come on, nigga!
All right, so that's Soldier Story. And anybody in this generation needs to go back and see that movie. Okay, I saw at least 5 times, 6 times in different time frames, right? And I always go back and I always see something, you read something and you see something and in the next 10 years you see it again, you're like, you got a message out of it or something. Like, you know what I'm saying? But Sarge wasn't playing. He didn't like lazy niggas, right? And, you know, I don't want to mess up the whole movie, right? But it's about getting with the program. Now, CJ got up with his little guitar and said, Sarge, there's nothing we can do, right? And he told CJ, sit your Geechee ass down. It's your down south niggas making us look stupid. See, it was a couple things I like about the Sarge, right? You know, he was down for not having lazy black people. He was with that. But it was another part that I hate the most about Sarge is that he had a vendetta. He had an agenda and he had it in for Down South Brothers. Like, I didn't like that, yo. I don't want to take the whole movie away from you. It's a very good movie. So all my young people that's not, you know, I'm 50, like I always say, go back to that movie and check it out. But Sarge had a part of him that I like, but he had another part of him that I did not like because he was setting up people that he didn't like personally, and he felt that these Negroes over here was making us look bad, where the Negroes that wasn't lazy is not getting the credit, right? So he was calling CJ, he was calling him a Geechee, right? A Geechee boy, you know, cackalacky down south and all that bullshit. So there was some parts that I liked about Sarge and some parts I don't. But have you noticed, right, when Peters said, where the fuck are you from, Sarge? Are you from England, sipping tea and shit? You all proper and shit, right? And then all the brothers that was sitting on this side went on the Sarge side. Sarge didn't have to say nothing. And these brothers got with the program. You see, let me explain something to you about this boxing shit, right? And these fans, because it's kind of irritating me. And the machine behind Errol Spence, right? When I say the machine, PBC, Al Heyman, right? Now, I'm not after them, okay? Because I got the same energy with ESPN, DAZN, whatever, when they ain't doing right, you're going to get this work. You're going to get the smoke. So I'm looking at it and I'm saying, wow, I remember when certain black people didn't want to get in line or get with the program, how they was outcasted by my own brothers. Our own brothers just say, oh man, you doing this? Nah. Let me give you an example. Let's roll the tape real quick.
It has been said that I have two alternatives. Either go to jail or go to the army. But I would like to say that there is another alternative. And that alternative is justice.
My conscience won't let me go shoot my brother or some poor hungry people in the mud for big powerful America and shoot them for what? They never called me nigger.
Ali more than held his own against students who had a far better formal education than he.
I'm not gonna help nobody get something my Negroes don't have. If I'm gonna die, I'll die now right here fighting you. If I'm gonna die, you my enemy. My enemy is a white people, not Vietcongs or Chinese or Japanese. You my opposer when I want freedom. You my opposer when I want justice. You my opposer when I want equality. You won't even stand up for me in America for my religious beliefs, and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
So, you know, there's a lot of people that were standing behind, a lot of brothers and sisters that were standing behind Muhammad Ali. But don't get this shit twisted, man. You had a lot of people that was against. I ain't got no yampi in my boogism and shit. I always got some shit on my face, man. And I be saying videos and I don't give a fuck. But there was a lot of black people that was against Muhammad Ali. Me, I would be like, yo, that's all good, man. Power to the people. I don't want to do that shit either, man. But there was a lot of people say you need to defend your country no matter what, or pay the consequences. And he paid the consequences. He stand his ground, right? But there's a lot of them saying, man, this nigga is too extra. He does not want to get in line with the program, right? And do what he's supposed to do. And I'm seeing this. I'm seeing this all over in boxing. I see there's brothers that's defining boxing as like, oh man, I don't want to, like, sign the fucking contract. Just sign the fucking contract. But what are we signing? If the man don't agree to sign a contract, do you know the terms in the contract? Do you know the term sheet turning into a contract? Just sign the contract. Why? Get in line. Get in line with the PBC. That's what. What you say, nigga? What you say? Ask me this again. Ask me one more fucking time. Ask me one more.
The question is, and if you have yet to answer, now this is my fourth time asking this same question, what does Terrence Crawford bring to the table that PBC needs to change their business model for him?
You want to know why they need to change their business? Because Errol Spence is asking for strap season, and Errol Spence got the machine behind him. And if Errol Spence wants this fight, who's the boss? Wait a minute, who's the fucking boss here? Is it Errol Spence or the promoter or the advisor?
So as you can see, he asked me four times, but now this is the fifth time he asked me because I had to revive that video. All right, so this is the fifth time he's asking me. So there's a situation where, you see, now, I'm not bashing Knockout 86 TV. I'm not a TV 86. You know, I'm not saying he's a PBC lover, but this is what fucking irks the fucking shit out of me with these Errol Spence fans. That's really pissing me off. When you start defending corporations, I don't care what it does. These boxers sweat, blood, and tears. Alright? And for you to use these motherfucking corporations so I could tell my boxer to get in line, get with the program. See, y'all wasn't with Muhammad Ali. That's what I'm seeing right now. Y'all the niggas that was on the other side. And I don't like that, man. I really don't like that. Now, you can see it any way you want it, but I'm seeing it this way. Because I ain't defending no big ass corporation. They're alright. They don't need my fucking, they don't need my dependency. Nah, they doing quite well. Matter of fact, they're doing so well that they can take people off that they don't care about, right? And say that we don't buy certain things and that's why we're not having to fight, or they could blame us saying, well, you know, we don't buy things. We don't do the gross domestic product. We don't buy, where we buy a lot in the United States. We buy a whole lot, right? But they blaming us for the piracy and with the pay-per-views, and it's the fans' fault. And you have a nerve to use that question to defend PBC why they should change death. As much shit going on with gas prices, food. Yo, these motherfuckers sucking the middle class dry. And I really don't like when I hear black, I'm fucking screaming, yeah. I don't like when I hear middle class or poor people defending motherfucker corporations on why the reasons why they can't, they need to change their ways of, for this one man. For this one man. Yeah, well, hey. And you know what? There's a lot of confusion with the Errol Spence fans, right? Because now, Knockout86 asked me this question, right? And then I hear from another Errol Spence, and this is a big Errol Spence, Texas. Yeah, man. Yeah. This man. Yeah. All right, let me let you listen. And you tell me which one is which. Who's the boss? Is it Errol Spence? It's a corporation, Al Heyman, Showtime, the network. Is it the boxer that makes the rules? Is it what the boxer asks? Come on, let's run this shit, man.
Hey, and this dude that keep coming here spamming and shit, talking about Tim Smith. Look, man, when it come to it, like I said, the PBC, and I know you don't want to hear this, the PBC, of course, they may not want Errol Spence to go outside and fight Terrence Crawford. Or without having Terrence Crawford in some kind of deal or whatever the case they might, or they might not want him in a deal. Who knows what the fuck the PBC wants? But like I said, it's ultimately going to be up to Errol Spence. Well, you got to listen to what I'm saying. I know it's beyond you guys' comprehension. Of course, they're going to compete with the whole Terrence Crawford situation. They're going to offer Errol Spence options. That's just a thing. And the in-house options are going to be more lucrative to them. Okay, this is something that Errol Spence got to do on his own. And I mean, of course, Al going to help him, but I said this is something that he's going to shoulder the responsibility on when he does this. He's gave the PBC what they asked him to do. Like I've said before, he's gave them that. And now he wants to fight this guy. That's what he wants. He wants this fight. Now, like I said, if the man don't take the fight, it ain't nothing that he can do about that.
So this, you see, listen. There's three things that Trill said. And go subscribe to him. I ain't got no hatred. Like I said, I grew up on these dudes. I watched them and shit like that. Go subscribe. CC is just hilarious. She's a character. They're all characters in their way. But just like he said, there's three things he said. He brought up Tim Smith. Tim Smith worked for the PBC. See, I got to do this because there's hardcore fans and there's casuals. And at the end of the day, I see a lot of brothers giving up on the Terrence and the Arrow fight, and now it's simmering down. But see, these big channels like Trill, Fanon, Best Fight the Best, and a lot more, they support Errol Spence. Some of them from Texas, most of them are from Texas, and they have a lot of subscribers. So they're going to get the last laugh or the last word. But small channels like me, I need to put this shit in detail. That's why I be making videos 30, 40 minutes. Because I'd like to do details here. But I know there's a lot of attention deficit disorder in this generation. So let me get straight to the point. Now, he said, Tim Smith. This is Tim Smith from the PBC, right here. This nigga. So you see a picture of this guy, right? And he said even before they started the fight, try to make this fight, he said, man, we don't want to embarrass, I got to tell these casuals, we don't want to embarrass Terrence Crawford with a guarantee that he's not used to getting. In other words, I rephrase it, but we don't want to embarrass him or, you know, in other words, PBC don't give high guarantees, right? The fact is, he was getting a $3 million guarantee with ESPN and Bob Arum Top Rank, right? And PBC only gives Tank Davis, Errol Spence, you know, 1.5 or 1 million. And then at the back end, they get whatever at the back end. So if it's 150,000 150,000 buys. After 150,000 buys, you get 3% off a dollar or whatever it is. But we're not talking about after the guarantee. We're talking about the guarantee itself. And the guarantee is this. Crawford get $3 million every fight. Tank Davis and Errol Spence and all anybody on that corporation over there gets 1.2, 1.5, whatever. And that was what this man said. Man, we don't want to embarrass him. This is what he said. This is a long time before they even try to negotiate the fight. And he said, man, we don't know if we're going to make that fight. So that's one. Now, another thing that Chill said was, man, if I can remember what he said. Let me go back and see what he said. Oh, okay. He said, of course the PBC going to try to give him in-house fights. It's more lucrative, right? But to me, yeah, it's more lucrative. But you feel the company, the corporation feels more safer with in-house fights. Yes. I mean, there's no more co-promotion. It's not top-ranked Bob Arum ESPN doing a co-promotion with Showtime and Al Heyman, the PBC. No, because what they asked for over here was, yo, Crawford, leave Top Rank. Leave Bob Arum. And the man did that. Did the man, go get a belt. Go get a belt. Well, that's what he did. He used his WBO Super World Champion belt. And they allow you to go up in weight or down in weight. So he went from 140. He came up to 147. Fought Jeff Horn, that beat Manny Pacquiao. Well, not beat Manny Pacquiao. They robbed Manny Pacquiao because the referee over there, right? Bob Arum and Duco Promotions in Australia, they had it in for Manny over there. They always get Manny at the end. The referee allowed headlocks, DDTs, suplexes, elbows, low blows, all this shit, roughing up Manny. But Manny held his own. Almost knocked him out in the ninth round. And then they robbed him. Then they robbed him, right? The man was still winning. But he got a petition, participation trophy. And since it was so close, they gave it to Jeff Horn. I said, hey, it's all right. It's all good. I'm going to get to that later, right? So after all this shit, he got a belt. He left the corporation of ESPN. And Top Rank. But to see, it's not Crawford's fault that he's not getting in line with the program, because the program that they want is that, man, we want you to have a 3-fight deal. We want you to have a 2 or 3-fight deal. We want you under us because we don't want you to do what you did to Bob Arum. And what did you do with Bob Arum? You took that WBO belt and you moved on and you're a free agent. And there's no, we don't have no control over you. Black man, we ain't got no control. We don't like this from this corporation. I don't care if the corporation's black, white, whatever it is. The race is green. And you're fucking up the green. You fucking up this. So we can't make this fight. It's better if this dude, Errol Spence, fight Keith Thurman or Standonius. One of those two. That's it. So you know what pissed me off? Let me show you what pissed me off. Because I'm telling you, these Errol Spence fans are using arguments defending the corporation on why Crawford won't get in line with the program.
Motherfuckers out here like a motherfucker talk about, you know, tell Al Heyman just pay Bud. Tell Al Heyman to pay Bud. So you want Al Heyman to pay Bud something that Bob Arum did not pay Bud. I don't remember any of you niggas telling Bob Arum, like, hey, what do you mean he don't sell? So what? Pay that man. I don't remember that. Nobody, no one was saying, no, fuck that, Bob Arum. It don't matter if he don't sell. Pay that man. Nobody was saying that.
So now he's even defending the PBC even more. And I'm thinking, like, are these niggas on the payroll or something? Because now he's like, whoa. You know, y'all asking PBC, and he said this in his. I didn't want to put the clip, but he's talking about you asking the blacks over here at the PBC to do something that Bob Arum didn't want to do. That's white. And I'm like, what? Okay, all right. This is, you know, what's going on. So I remember in my last video with the Labor Day joint, And I said that, you know, Crawford asked Bob Arum for the fight, for the Errol Spence fight. And, you know, co-promotions, you know, and also, and that asking for Errol Spence, he asked for $10 million, right? Now, that was then. Now, they're saying it. Now, the Errol Spence said, fans are saying that it's $20 million that Crawford's asking or whatever, right? But who knows what Spence asking? He's the one with the three belts, right? Y'all the one that say he needs to get the bigger pie. So y'all just talking about what Crawford want. You ain't even asking what Errol Spence want. All right? So all I'm saying is that in that breach of contract that Crawford sued him, he asked for these things. All right? That's one. And we know that co-promotions don't mix like two dicks. That's the way it is, man. So this man seems like he's defending, because he's wondering why ESPN. let's move on. Let's move on. I'm just wondering, is this man on the payroll of the people? This is what I don't like. Why y'all bringing these corporations up and saying why this one didn't do this and one that one? Bro, come on, man.
Top Rank makes over 20 million, not Top Rank, ESPN makes over $20 million a month. A month. In YouTube AdSense. They make $20 million a month in YouTube AdSense, y'all. Over $20 million. They made $26 million in August of last year. They make 20 plus million a month in YouTube. 20 plus million a month. Why didn't Budrick get 20 million guaranteed when he was with a network that makes 20 plus million a month?
Busted, dusted, and disgusted, yo. This dude, man. So he's trying to explain shit about ESPN, why he died. He didn't get 20 million guaranteed instead of 3 million. He's shooting for some kind of star and galaxy out there in the atmosphere, right? And then he's going to say why they didn't pay for the fight. Bro, who has Errol Spence? Al Heyman. That's the advisor, right? And then y'all had the nerve to tell this man to leave them, leave Bob Arum, so we could get a fight. But see, this is where y'all went wrong, because Crawford... You see, this is where y'all went wrong. PBC was trying to offer Canelo all this money for a Charlo, a Spence fight, and this and that. And he's seen this. He's like, God damn, I've seen all this money. Like, y'all got money like that, right? Fine, y'all got money like that, right? But see, I'm not going to use this Canelo argument. You know why? About the money, because everybody could always come back and say, well, he has revenue that could come back because he sells, and Bud Crawford don't sell. So what I'm going to say is, why couldn't you just... I'm not even going by that. I'm going by the one fight deal. I mean, you gave Canelo the opportunity to say hi and bye. One fight. And then you wanted him to come back because you needed him. But you offered him a one fight deal. Now, I'm going to end this because, you know, the attention deficit disorder, you know, I know... It's getting about that long. But I'm going to show you that it's a fight by fight. The Muhammad Ali act. And then I'll move on to another video tomorrow or whatever. But I'm not here to change your mind. I'm here for you to read between the lines. And when these dudes come up with their own lines, I got to come up with my lines, man. And all I'm seeing is why this and why that and why ESPN is, why Showtime, and these niggas always asking why. And the only thing I can say about a letter why and why you want to ask why, well, why is a letter with a long tail. That's all it is. It's a word. It's a fucking letter with a long tail. And that's the fucking question you're going to get with a fucking why. That's it. So I'm not here to change your mind. Wait, you know what? Let me just refresh your memory of the Muhammad Ali act, because it's just a one fight deal, and you gave this Canelo. Fuck that Canelo could bring back revenue. All we want to know is that why you can't do that with Bud. And then you telling him he need to get in line with the PBC. He need to get in line with the PBC. Oh, I got more for you, man. I got more for you. See, when things are simmering down, that's when I'm starting to heat up, man. But y'all definitely on the wrong side of Muhammad Ali. Y'all definitely on the wrong side of someone that have 10 toes down and trying to get what he wants, what he think he's worth. Don't ask me what the fuck Crawford's worth. I don't know what he's worth. He knows what he's worth. And he's telling the corporation this is what it is. Get with his program or keep him, yo, skip to your loo. And that's the way it is, man. Come on. I did my little research, just like anybody else can, so I'm not doing nothing special, but pertaining to this video, it says 1 year, and underneath 1 year, it says the most significant provision in the bill affecting promoters is 1 year limit on the promotion contracts that the boxer is required to sign in order to participate in a match against another boxer under contract to the promoter. And under that, it says Senate Report 106-83 Muhammad Ali Boxing Reform Act. So that's it. Let me just click it. Click. This is very simple, bro. Now, all this right here, as soon as I touch it, but you can see it's highlighted right here. So as soon as I touch it, it's going to be off highlighted. I got to be very detailed because I got niggas watching and they always have an excuse. So watch when I touch it. But I already see the paragraph. I'm going to zoom in. There you go. So I'm going to zoom in, right? Now it says, the most, let me move in a little bit more for niggas. The most significant provision in the bill affecting promoters is the 1 year limit on promotion contracts that the boxer is required to sign in order to participate in a match against another boxer under contract to the promoters based on the information from industry sources, CBO. So it says right here. Now, if you don't believe me, this is the Muhammad Ali Act, niggas. Watch me scroll all the way up. Watch. Yes. Let me scroll all the way up. See? It says Senate Muhammad Ali Reform Act Report on Committee of Commerce, Science, and Transportation, Section 305, June 21st, 1999, order in the printed, Government Printed Office, Washington, 1999, right? Committee of Commerce, Science, and Transportation again. John McCain, Arizona. So all this came around that time. You see? All this is the Muhammad Ali Act. All right? So